Once in a while, we get the question, why can't I be cryopreserved while I'm alive? And then, you know, come back after 20 years or 30 years or, you know, take a break in quotation marks and then be taken out of cryopreservation. Either that, or why can't I be cryopreserved whenever I want to? And then, you know, be woken up, let's say 100 years in the future, and I just make this a choice. I think there's a lot of, first of all, ethical and moral reasons why I don't think this is a good idea. I think people should live as long as they humanly can, and then only choose cryopreservation if the alternative is cremation or burial. But to be fair, this is a very personal decision. Everybody, I think in my mind, should be able to make that decision however they think they should make it. From a quality perspective of cryopreservation, it makes sense to wait the longest possible amount of time to be cryopreserved. Because it's very important to remember, even though cryopreservation has been around for many, many decades as a technology, there's a tremendous amount of things that need to be improved, from the quality of how much ice formation happens, how good cryopreservation can be done without having ice crystals form, to the reduction of toxicity, to very novel potential rewarming technologies that would need an altercation of the cryoprotective agent that is being used. Basically, the longer you wait, the more technological advances would be employed for your cryopreservation. So most likely, as much as we understand it right now, cryopreservation will be a last in, first out principle. So the person who has been cryopreserved with the best technology in the future, the person who has been cryopreserved the last, will likely be the person who will be woken up first. The reason for that is basically, if you go 50 years back, 30 years back, or 20 years back, the cryopreservation quality, the average cryopreservation quality, was significantly lower than it is today, even though, at least in my mind, quality has not improved enough. So one of the things that we do is very, very actively work on making improvements in quality faster. But definitely a cryopreservation 10 years from now, or 20 years from now, will be significantly better than any cryopreservation right now. And in fact, it's not about only being woken up earlier or later. Big advantage here being that the future would progress more and more, and you probably want to be woken up in a future that is not so much farther in the future, because the farther it is, the less you might be able to get, you know, used to however society and technology works in that future, right? So it's easier to get reintegrated into the future or future society if the future has not progressed that much. So that is one part. The second main reason would be that there might be a threshold where, if you've been cryopreserved with lower quality earlier, that it might be very difficult, if not impossible, to bring someone back from cryopreservation who has been cryopreserved with lower fidelity, lower quality. I'm pretty confident that under ideal or even good circumstances, the cryopreservation quality has already surpassed this line where revival is, I don't want to say likely, but at least has a good chance. But of course, not every cryopreservation on average is being done in these ideal or very good conditions. There are, of course, also cryopreservations which are done under non-ideal circumstances. And if you just wait 20 years, then in 20 years from now, probably compared to today, a non-ideal cryopreservation would have a significantly better quality than a cryopreservation under non-ideal circumstances right now. So to optimize the chance that you are being brought back from cryostasis in the, say, 50 years, 75, 100, or even longer years in the future, probably the best to be cryopreserved with the as futuristic as possible technology. So wait the longest possible amount of time, then be cryopreserved at the latest possible point in time. I think the only exception to that is if there's certain types of neurodegenerative diseases, diseases where the longer you wait, what makes you you basically is destroyed due to this disease. Vascular dementia and so on. So there are certain neurological and neurodegenerative diseases where the part that makes you you, the longer you wait, basically goes away. I think there are some of these edge cases, but by and large, waiting the longest possible amount of time is probably best. From a legal standpoint, of course, cryopreservation is only possible after the person has legally been pronounced. So you can't just say, I want to do cryopreservation tomorrow as an elective medical procedure or anything like that. You need to be legally pronounced. And only after that, cryopreservation can be done. So the main considerations here are quality and ethical and moral considerations. If you want to learn more about the ethical considerations of cryopreservation, check out this video over here. And of course, if you want to discuss these topics with us in person or have any questions that you would like to answer, feel free to reach out at any point. Just go to tomorrow.bio and find any of the contact options and just reach out to us. Until next time, see you around.